I got out an old video that a friend of mine, Vin Kakamisi, made when we took a ride in my Aeronca Champ on a Sunday afternoon along the North Shore, north of Boston. Vinny and I have been friends for quite some time. He and I had our boys together in Cub Scouts and been friends ever since, along the same model airplane club. And he did a rather nice job on this video, except for the reason I have to do this introduction is he didn't do much in the way of narration of what's going on. So anyhow, we took off out of Tewksbury, Tumac Airport, and we headed easterly along the Merrimack River to where Newburyport is and where the river comes out into the ocean at Plum Island. We flew south along Plum Island, down along Crane's Beach, Crane's Castle, took a look at the Anasquam River, flew out around Cape Ann to Newburyport, Rockport, flew a circle over Rockport Harbor, down along the coast over an island, I'm not sure, it might be Thatcher's Island, but it has two lighthouses on it, rather interesting footage. And then continued south along the coast to Gloucester, crossed back over the Anasquam River, back to Crane's Beach, flew north again past the mouth of the Merrimack River towards Salisbury Beach and then past the nuclear reactor at Seabrook, and we did a short takeoff and landing at Hampton Field, the grass strip in Hampton, New Hampshire, and then flew westerly along the Merrimack and back to Tumac. And it's I think you'll enjoy the ride. Vinny did a pretty good job, I think, in the film footage, and here it is.
Surfaces around. So we untie the stick. We can hook up the shoulder harnesses that go with that. The next thing we look for is if the throttle's in the closed position. The ignition is off. And I'm going to put the fuel on. The reason I'm going to put the fuel on is I'm going to want to dump a sump in the front and I want it to be able to flow freely. And then we start here, we take a little fuel sample, and you can see with all the moisture we've had, we've got a little water in the bottom of that, so we've drained that sump out. This one has no water, that's free of water. We have a third low point down here, where we get a fuel sample. Everything's clean there, so only the right tank had a little water in it. Place we put our attention is up into the engine compartment. A lot of people will make a mistake on a Champ of pushing this up in the air to get in at the oil stick. Well, eventually they'll crack this across here, so we'll take two more fasteners. We'll loosen those. It's nice and flexible now. We can now get inside, take a look at the oil stick. And we got plenty of oil in there. It's nice and clean. And way down in here, I don't know if you can see it or not, there's a gascolator bowl. And we're going to reach in there, we're going to dump a little fuel out of that, make sure there's no water in that. We take a quick look around, make sure the birds and the bees haven't done anything to it, building nests in it. Everything looks reasonable. that takes care of the engine compartment. Then we start at the trailing edge, straightness of the trailing edge, make sure that there's been no distortion to that. Make sure all the fasteners that are holding the hinges in place on the aileron are all in place. Take a quick look at the linkage. Check for freedom movement on the aileron. Then you walk through the wingtip, make sure that nothing has bent that since you've seen it last. Everything's straight, the leading edge isn't buckled. We've got a fastener back in here. I always check to see what's there. The rear strut, the fasteners are up inside, so we can't really see those. But the jerry strut fasteners are all in place. Take a quick look in here to see that the fuel tank is clear. We have a vent here for the fuel tank. I'd like to take a quick look and see if any mud wash to plug that up for me so we have an open vent for the fuel tank. And then I look at the fasteners landing gear and take a quick look to make sure that the brake cable is moving. Tires look okay. Check all the fasteners on the cowl. Everything looks like it should be. Then we come to the leading edge of the prop and we check the prop to see if the leading edge has any nicks in it. There's no nicks in the leading edge. Take a quick look inside the cowl. Again, looking for bird's nests or anything that may have, foreign objects may have gotten inside. We can pull the prop through, get a little oil, move around inside. And we repeat the same thing on the other side, looking at the fasteners on the cowl. Everything's in place where it should be. And get back down to the fasteners on the landing gear. Take a look at the cable for the brake, make sure that's riding properly, the tire looks properly inflated. Move back again, the gear struts on this side. And back around the wingtip. Repeat the same procedure on this side. One thing that's interesting where we've had a rainstorm here is, I don't know if you can see it, but the trailing edge of all these moving surfaces have drain holes in them. So if it accumulates any moisture, by warm, moist air being drawn out in and then cooling and condensing, has a place for it to bleed out so we don't collect water inside the aileron. Then we move on to the tail surface. I usually check to see that the stop nut is on here. The fasteners on the tie wires for the horizontal stabilizer are all in place and got it. I check the cable, make sure I don't see it changing on the cable. Look to see that the cotter pins are still in place on the hinges and that everything's moving freely. We're not binding on anything. And I like to look at the cables on the trim tab just to see what kind of shape they're in. Then you get to the rudder, it's the same procedure. Do we have cotter pins? We move the rudder to make sure it's moving freely. I like to check these springs on the tail. I had one come off once and that gets to be an exciting event. So these are safety wired. And I always like to look to see the safety wires are still in place on it. Also, we have a shim here, and I like to make sure that shim hasn't moved around any, that the tension with the tail spring's keeping that in place. And then we come there. The flying wires are nice and tight. There's nothing loose on the appendages. And that brings us back to where we started, and that's pretty much the pre-flight for the airplane. Open the cylinders, we'll crack the throttle open just a little bit, and we'll put both magnetos on. Until it warms up a bit while I get the ropes off it.